I would like to get going by asking you, what is your view and experience for clinical trial recruitment, especially in underrepresented or underserved populations?
Stefan, I've had experience of being part of a number of trials, both as an investigator for investigator-generated trials, as well as someone who's been part of multinational, multicentric trials. There are problems when you look at the underrepresented population and oncology trials. There's gender issues, cultural, there's misinformation, lack of information, language, socioeconomic factors, beliefs, religions. But all I can say is being part of trials, all these can be overcome. You all do so many trials. What is your experience? Have you observed a lack of enrollment in Roche trials specifically?
I mean, a clinical trial enrollment per se is not so common. I mean, in general, in oncology, less than 5% of treated patients even participate in clinical trials. There are some countries where it's more frequent, like the United Kingdom, but in others, a lot less.
It's mandatory that we overcome these hurdles when we look at the underrepresented population, because if we don't and we only enroll patients of a particular denomination into our trials, there's always that little conflict of interest that could come into play. And the other thing is that if you have the entire population well represented in your trial, findings of them then could be extrapolated and it could be applicable to the entire population which has been studied. So I guess there are problems, but they can be overcome.
Yeah, can't agree more. And I believe that next to trial design, certainly the conduct is important. Like you mentioned, when we want to run it across the globe to have a representation across the entire world, we need to ensure that it is happening. I still would like to add a point that I believe the biologic rationale for certain diseases. In breast cancer, we have many drugs which we studied, and typically we enroll female patients, but 1 out of 100, even male patients are affected. And we certainly would want that male patients with breast cancer have ultimately access to the drug. They need to be represented. Typically, we only have a handful of patients in there. And at least in some areas, we may use later on real-world data in order to, demonstrate that the outcome in this population is rather similar to what we have observed in clinical trials to strengthen the case and that patients will feel comfortable that those data can be extrapolated.
Again, Stefan, totally agree with what you say. And I'll draw an example from the specialty which I treat, and that's head and neck cancer. Mm-hmm. If you look at the incidence and the epidemiology of oropharyngeal cancers, which is the tonsil and the base of the tongue, today in the Western population, 85% are non-tobacco. They are caused predominantly by the HPV virus, the human papilloma virus that causes cervical cancer. In our part of the world, 85 to 90% of the cancers are still tobacco related. So now if you have a trial on oropharyngeal cancers, looking at various drugs, looking at various operative modalities, like whether the robotic resection is worth it, you have two disparate populations. So yes, I totally agree with you that you have to factor these into the algorithm when you plan a trial.
Have now used two examples where the pathogenesis is different. When we look at breast cancer again, we do know that African Americans or females with African origin have a worse prognosis, but we don't necessarily understand the biologic mechanism why it's happening. And then again, it is important for us to recruit patients with a diverse ethnicity if we detect difference in prognosis, or maybe even whether it's predictive. So do we have a differential drug effect? Currently, we assume, I believe, in cancer, it's a mutational-driven disease that a mutation in one ethnicity can be easily extrapolated across the globe because the pathogenesis and the biology of the disease is different. But sometimes it may make sense to actually confirm that the biology and the cause of disease and then the genetic foundation is very similar. And I believe there it's our role as well during early trials to confirm or refute those findings.